Talking about Luis' fight, did you watch it?
Oh yeah, great.
That Brazilian gold medalist was hitting him low. He got dropped. Let me ask you guys a question. If someone hits you low, do you hit him low back or no?
Hell yeah.
No, you said hell yeah?
I beat the ass even more.
What do you do? Someone's hitting you low and they deducted 2 points already. Adam, what do you do? Someone hits you low and they took away 2 points.
When it becomes excessive, I don't know.
You like that word excessive? Yeah, see how big word are you?
How do you spell it?
I don't know.
Excessive.
There you go.
No, because a lot of people say don't retaliate. But I think if you hit him back once, then he'll stop doing it.
Yeah.
Buddy,
do something, you
know. What if I hit him back and they stop doing it? Not worth it? They took away 2 points for it already.
If they already took 2 points, you should feel you ahead of the... I really can't answer that.
But they robbed Louis. Let's be honest. Adam, he won the fight, right?
I watched it over again.
Yeah.
And Louis was taking a lot of shots.
But with the 4 points, he dropped him and...
With the points, it should have been a little closer, but...
Was it unanimous?
I think it was unanimous.
I thought he won, clearly.
Did you watch... How many times did you watch it?
Just when it's live. And I was watching it on a little phone. I was at the venue.
Watch it again. I was the same way. I thought he won, and then I watched it over, and Louis might not have gotten that one.
What did you think of Tank's fight?
That was a great fight.
Who were you going for before?
I wasn't really going for nobody. I just thought Tank was going to beat him. Too much power.
Did you see that knockout?
Yeah.
That uppercut?
Very impressive.
That was...
Very impressive.
That was a big uppercut.
Yeah, it was.
And,
It was scary.
The setup, like Tank's so smart, he figured out, like, oh, this guy keep throwing jabs at me. I'm going to sneak in there and take advantage.
Yeah, he threw that right hand one too many times. But he should know better. I don't know. He slept on that.
That was the same shot he caught a homeboy in the gym right here with.
Ivan, when they sparred.
Slipped through that uppercut, same shot.
Well, when you're a southpaw and someone throws a jab at you, that's the punch, right?
But if you look at three right hands, he was southpaw at first. Second right hand, he switched. Third right hand, he was orthodox, and he threw that uppercut with orthodox hand.
But
that's what I was saying. Three right
but you know what's crazy, Adam? Right. Now that Tank won, and Buddy told me that this is boxing, but it's not right. Now that he won, they're finding every excuse to discredit his win.
Yeah, of course.
Why, of course?
People hate. They just hate.
Why can't they just be like, wow, that was an impressive fight, an impressive ending, impressive win? He fought a 4-division champ.
It was a good win. Ain't no excuse.
No, but on the online, the internet.
Yeah.
Do you hear what they were saying?
About the gloves, how you pick the gloves.
As a fighter, you get two pairs of gloves, right?
Yeah.
Reporting, what gloves do you usually fight with?
Whichever ones you want to pick, I don't know.
Okay, but if you want to switch them, you can switch them, right? The commissioner.
Danny, I've always, whatever ones I pick, I just use those ones. I'm not too
picky. No, he's saying, like, what brand? So,
yeah.
When you in a championship fight like that, you can pick your brand.
Correct.
Yeah.
So basically what I'm saying is both gloves were approved. He didn't like the grant for some reason, and he switched to winning.
Okay.
And people, you know, conspiracy theory who don't follow boxing don't know that you get two pairs. Thought that he brought them from home and they were in his backpack and he pulled them out.
They got to get checked.
The commission holds on to them. And in fact, you never get a chance to punch anything. You could try them on once after the weigh-in.
Yeah.
And your opponent could try them on and sign off on them.
Package and everything. You can't even like open them up.
No. You can't start, hey, buddy, let's do mitts for 30 seconds so I can feel it.
No.
Plus, the feel of gloves. Buddy, when you have hand wraps on, the gloves feel totally different than with no hand wraps.
Yeah,
so
sure.
Once he had hand wraps on, he didn't like the feel. He switched.
But he's got that right.
Yeah, he can switch gloves.
Yeah, but I'm saying that's one thing. So
it's not like he switched in between rounds.
No. We've seen that too sometimes. What was that, Ali, where the trainer cut the glove to buy him some time?
Yeah.
Or one is one where they rip the tape a little bit, buddy. So you come out from the corner and the tape's loose. And they're like, okay, time out. Yeah, then the other thing they said, oh, Leo's small. That's not what you were saying a week ago, and Leo's taller physically.
Leo came in good shape. He looked really ready.
He looked massive. And it was a good fight.
It was a good fight. He threw that right hand too many times.
But things happen in fights.
He got comfortable enough with the right hand. And he was doing good with the right hand, but he was not. He got a little too comfortable.
So what you're saying is it's all about adjustments.
And they don't call him the Tank for nothing.
I said that punch was a missile.
Yeah, it was.
But it's funny because no matter what you do in life, people are still going to try to find something to say. Like,
what is that?
But why is that, buddy? Why can't you just say, wow, that was impressive. Leave it at that. That
haters,
was good.
Man, you get haters, bro.
A lot of them can't do what he's doing, so they hate him.
They just predetermined that they don't like him, and that was it.
Not even you not liking. Just haters, bro. A lot of people want to be where he's at right now.
Yeah.
And I believe that it will come if you just work.
Stay focused.
Stop worrying about what the next man is doing. Focus on what you got to do.
Yeah.
Exactly.
That's true. Hey, taking out someone else's light doesn't shine yours any brighter, right?
Not at all.
That's right. Any setback.
Reporting. But yeah, being in the bubble wasn't easy. I'm not going to lie. I couldn't leave my room. I talked a lot to Ronnie Shield because he was there a lot, and to Bones Adams. But we could only leave the room for like an hour a day, like something like that.
What?
Yeah.
Bubble, man.
And the first 2 days, they deliver you food because you get tested. They knock on the door, leave the food, and take off.
They didn't do that with us.
You tell you contested. Yeah.
What's that?
They didn't do that with us.
So you... That's like being in a mean prison, you're going, you can't come out. That's fucked up.
Yeah, but it's safety, and everybody's trying to make sure everyone's safe.
Safety, yeah.